Hello, today I figured I'd do something different for a change. Well, two things. First thing is using a tripod. See, there's no shake and both my hands are here so I can actually demonstrate things. And secondly, to do a video that's not about electronics or radio or music or any other electronically related stuff. One of my other hobbies, besides anything related to electronics, is film. And that includes still and moving picture film, negatives, and reversal film. Reversal, for those that don't know, is films such as slide and projectable films such as Super 8 16mm. I'm today going to show you this developing tank, which some of you may be familiar with, others may not, or at least maybe know the name. It is known as the Morse G3 development tank. It is what they call a rewind tank. Most development tanks, you pretty much just put on a spiral reel. Put my finger there, spiral, just in case you're hard of hearing. And you immerse it in the liquid and, you know, shake it and pour it out one after the other. With a rewind tank, what you have is two reels internally, and you wind one, all the film to one end through the liquid, and then when it's wound that way, you wind it back. I'll show you what I mean. I'll just open this little fella here. So you can see there are two reels on the lid. You got your, these are on the other end of the little cranky things, cranks, whatever you call them. Oh yeah, while I've got the close up over there, this is where you actually pour your liquids in. Inside you got two reels, both of them look like this. This tank can do both 16mm and if you're rich, 35mm. By just clicking it like that, now it's 35mm. Each reel takes about 100 feet or so. I use 16mm for all my films. Well, when I'm not using 8mm or Super 8. Now, pardon me while I move this up. As you can see, just these turn rather freely. That one rattles a bit. Alright, important things to take note of if any of you've done the reversal process. What you got to do is develop it once, then bleach, and then clear. And before the second developer, you got to shine a light onto the film. So you can see there's a little window there. You can see my fingertip. When you actually wind it through, the film goes over there. You just shine a light into it. It's all well and good. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to show you the film path, how it goes. If this little fella can go out, if I can do this without swearing, there I go, I've succeeded. Now you can just sort of see on the inside, there's like a little roller there. That's so when it gets, you know, pushes it near the window, so when you shine the light in, two reels. What I'm going to do is demonstrate to you how to actually load this thing. Now, usually you do it in a changing bag, but no point me demonstrating it by doing a changing bag because you won't see what I'm doing. I've got this old disposable roll of 16mm double perforation stuff. Just to prove it to you, it's just a junk reel. It's probably old Kodachrome. I just use it just to sort of run through my cameras when I'm testing them, just to make sure this doesn't jam or anything weird's happening before I actually use it out. So, yeah, next scene, I'm gonna, jumping ahead of myself there. Okay, the way this film is wound, you got the base on the outside, emulsion on the inside. Those that don't know, the emulsion is the photosensitive layer. Now what one has to do is wind it on the reel's emulsion side out. So, let's get to that, shall we? Alright, this may be a bit awkward for you because you've got a close-up of my crotch, but ignore that. It's just that I like working in my lap. Here's one of the reels, a close-up of it. You'll notice there's like a little notch that runs here. What that is, like a little clamp in there, you basically slip the film into that notch and then clamp it. As I said, you need to put it the emulsion side out. Now, take note, you'll be doing all of this in the dark. You wouldn't be doing it out in the open, but no point me showing this to you in the dark. So, I'm going to pop the film in there. Let me just see that I'm doing this right. Yes, pop the film in the slot. Get in there. See, it's in there, emulsion side out, and then clamp it shut. Should click, there it goes. It's nice and tight. Now, what I'll be doing... Whoa. Aren't I a clumsy bastard? All right, let me just move that out of the way. There we go. So, I'll be pulling this reel out, popping both of these in. Do, 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 do. That reel over there. This reel over here. And then the phone ring. Just in time for me to pose this. I'll be back. Okay, phone call's over. Where was I? Alright, here we are. See the film reel? The actual development reel. Emulsion side out. So then you just pop the lid on. Obviously you don't want the reversal window open. Just while that's tight. And you turn this bugger until it's all off. It's a bit noisy, but you know, this is, I don't know, 1940s, 1950s technology. Now, just imagine that this is the actual processing part of it. You know, you'll be running it back and forth from one reel to another. You'd want to have bloody good wrists, you know, really, and keeping count and all that can be a bit tedious, but the results are worth it. Just make sure there's no one else around to bother you. Hey, there we go, we've reached the end. Make sure there's no one else to bother you, because after all, you've got to keep count. All right, there it is. We've reached the end of the film, as you can see, sort of curling out like so. Now you want to wedge that in to the other reel. Am I in shot? Yes, I'm in shot. Good-o. For that, just plonk. Is my hand in the way? This is a bit awkward. How about if I pop this little fella down? There we go. Where's that wee slot? There it is. Plonk it in there. Once again, let me reiterate. I can't reiterate these things too many times. I'd be doing this in a lightproof bag. Otherwise, I'd be ruining my valuable film. Sorry, this film is really, really, really old. Like I said, it's junk, so ow, I just spiked myself on a pointy bit and I'm bleeding. Oh well, can't really do these things without a wee bit of comedy. I'll pull that out. Here we go. Right. Now, here we are. Emulsion side out. See, there it is. The emulsion, the base. And you pop that little fella in. To there. To there. There we go. Let me just pull that out. This little fella here. There we go. Alright, I'm not sure how well you can see it. Just move that out of the way. The film is actually going around that roller. So, when you do the reversal stage, assuming you're doing reversal, there it is in the window. So when you re-expose it, you can see it like that. Bob's your uncle. Now, assuming this is still in the light-proof bag and the reversal window shut, click. Lid goes back on, secured, right, Now, when you'd be running it through the chemicals, you'd be churning it somewhat like that. So pretty much for every 100, for 100 feet, it'll take approximately a minute to go from one reel to another. And that would be one cycle. See, told you I'm bleeding. Ow. So yeah. Whereas with spiral reels and other such tanks, you'd be measuring it via time. This would be, you know, how many turns or times it goes from one reel to another. So emptying this reel to this would be one cycle, emptying this reel to that would be two, yada, yada, yada. As you can imagine, it can be relatively tedious. Now, chemicals go through the top, come out from the bottom via this. Now, as I mentioned, it's always best not to be interrupted unless you lose count, because if you lose count, you potentially screw up your film. It's also important to keep a rather regular pace when you're turning, and be constant, because if you stop any time, there's a certain bit amount of film from, say, about here to here, which will get a bit more development or a bit more of a chemical bath than any of the others. Therefore, you get, I don't know, a bit of impurity, a bit of a weird look, sometimes flickering, a few frames that look a bit bright, etc. So as long as you stay constant, don't lose count, everything is cool. So you should be sweet. Yes, I'm actually going to be processing some film tomorrow. Some Fomapan 100R. I may show you what that looks like. I'm not going to be sitting there recording what I'm doing. As I said, you know, you don't want to lose count, so I'm going to have to put 100% concentration into doing that. But, yeah. Maybe this is enough for you to get to actually learn how to do this. You know, these are relatively common-ish. You know, enough people know about them, so they must be common. Modern variants don't actually have the window. Film says hello. So you can't do reverse linen, but the older ones do. Just to give you an idea what I was talking about before, this little piece of paper on the wall, which has been sitting here for about a year, sort of a method, recipe, whatever you may say or call it, that I used to develop some Fomapan 100R. As you can see, it's got the steps for reversal, wash, develop, first developer, wash, bleach, wash, clear, wash, re-expose, develop, number two, wash, fix, and a lot of washing. As you can see over here, it's not measured in minutes. This is how many times you want to go through one reel to another. So let's just say we're going from right to left is one. Left to right is two, so two rounds for the wash, 14 rounds for the developer, four times for the wash, 10 times for the bleach, four times for the wash, eight times for the clear, two times for another wash, four times for re-exposure, 10 times for the second developer, four times for the another wash, 10 times for the fix, and wash to get rid of the last of the fixer. As you can see, turning your hand and cranking it from one end to another can be rather tedious, but it is rather rewarding, because at the end of it, even though your arms may feel like they're made out of rubber, what you get is lovely. And we'll prove it to you in a wee link below. I don't think they make spiral tanks for 100 feet. I know those Lomo tanks, you can do two layers of 50 feet, one above the other. But I do not like cutting up my film, especially 100 foot reels, and then having to re-splice it because I'll lose frames. So hence I use the rewind tank. This is the way I do it. I believe for Tri-X you'd only have to do 12 times for the first developer as opposed to 14 for the Fomapan. I don't know how many times it is for the Orlo. I think it is 12 times, but I'll find out. I've got four rolls of the Orwo UN54. So yeah, this may give you something to go by. As I said, feel free to ask me any questions. I've done this a few times. So anything to help, because I like to keep film alive, especially 16mm and 8mm and various other reversal films. you know, as long as it remains popular, they'll continue making it, and people like me will still be able to have it as a hobby. So until next time, have fun.